couple of weeks, I've been busy. Like, really, really busy.
Heat waves on land.
It has consequences for ocean currents.
It is changing, and it's changing before our very eyes.
What happens at the poles does affect us all.
Climate change is being especially relentless this year, and my phone has been ringing off the hook about all the extreme weather it's causing. The science tells us that as we heat our atmosphere and oceans, extreme events get more frequent, more severe, and more prolonged. And we only have to look at this summer's headlines to see that. 52 degrees in China, wildfires turning the skies of North America an apocalyptic red, a blistering heat wave gripping Europe and taking the lives of workers, the world's two hottest months on record, and most recently, the devastating wildfires in Maui. But all of these examples seem pretty far from the poles, so you might be wondering, why is this video about Antarctica? I'm Ella, a polar scientist with a PhD in Antarctic climate change. And in this video, I'm going to show you how extreme events are reshaping even our coldest and remotest continent. Some colleagues of mine recently published some work drawing together evidence of how extremes are transforming Antarctica. I even went to sit on the Sky News sofa to talk about
We've seen ice shelves collapsing. We're seeing a completely astounding low in the amount of floating sea ice in the ocean at the moment in Antarctica.
You might be thinking, who cares? But you should care, and here's why. Antarctica is vital for our planet. It's the engine of global ocean circulation and keeps our planet cool by reflecting incoming solar energy. If Antarctica changes, everything changes. The icy continent contains enough ice to raise global sea levels by 58 metres. And if we carry on as we are, we could be in for multiple metres of sea level rise in the next couple of centuries. Especially pushing past irreversible tipping points would trigger the loss of huge amounts of ice and lock us into that fate for, well, it might as well be forever on our puny human timescales. Fossil fuel burning has raised global temperatures by 1.2 degrees C and increased ice losses from Antarctica by 6 times compared to where they were just 3 decades ago. And while extremes in Antarctica might not have the same effects as they do in warmer climes, they can still have a profound impact on the local environment and global climate. For instance, extremes in the ocean like marine heat waves can impact sea life and ripple through entire ecosystems. Changes to Antarctic weather or sea ice conditions can mean the difference between life and death for wildlife, especially in crucial breeding seasons. And extreme events can compound into cascades that produce much larger changes too. In March 2022, a mega heat wave gripped the East Antarctic, causing temperatures to rise by nearly 40 degrees in just a few hours. That kind of temperature change is bonkers. Of course, this being East Antarctica, temperatures didn't quite reach the melting point, but they don't have to reach 0 degrees to have an impact on ice. Whilst melting is a very real risk at low elevations around the edges of the ice sheets, any kind of warming can change the behaviour of ice. Warmer temperatures can cause glaciers to flow faster because it changes the properties of the ice. And faster glaciers mean more ice is getting into the oceans. But let's zoom in on a little floating ice shelf in East Antarctica. It's about the size of Rome and it's called the Conger Ice Shelf. By 2022, Conger had been thinning and weakening for several years, mostly driven by warm ocean waters undercutting the ice. You might be sick of hearing me banging on about Antarctic sea ice, like in this video and this video, but as a bit of context, in March 2022, Antarctic sea ice had just blown through the 2 million square kilometre threshold for the first time on record. It was an unprecedented low year. The lack of sea ice meant floating ice shelves around the edges of the continent had less of a protective shield against the waves in the surrounding ocean. Ice shelves, like the Conger Ice Shelf. Then came that crazy heat wave, and that was the straw that broke the camel's back. Without the stabilizing effect of sea ice to glue the ice shelf in place, and triggered by the wildly hotter temperatures, the Conger Ice Shelf finally gave way and collapsed on the 15th of March. This is just one example of how the background trend of rising temperatures is weakening and preconditioning the polar environment to change. And whilst ice shelves do collapse due to natural processes, when it comes against the backdrop of ongoing change and is triggered by extreme events exacerbated by climate change, it's clear to see that these sorts of events are likely to become more frequent in future. One of the most important take-home messages of this report is that human activity is virtually certain to have increased the frequency and severity of extremes we're already seeing in Antarctica. And the authors go on to say that the implications of this are especially concerning because we are already committed to more warming, even if the most stringent 1.5 degree target is met. What I take from this is that every fraction of a degree matters, and every action we take to reduce warming has a benefit. Because the less warming we cause, the fewer extremes we will see, and the lower the risk of triggering dramatic changes that could reshape Antarctica and the world. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and you'd like to help me keep them independent and ad-free, please consider signing up to my Patreon. The link's down here. Till next time!